Hey guys, welcome back to another very exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess Channel. In this video, we're designing this logo. And this logo, we have got a nice sphere in the background, and on the top, we have got a nice 3D text of alphabet A, and it has got a nice gradient color, and it has got a nice reflection and shadows. So we're designing this logo in three steps. First, we'll create the sphere in the background, then we'll create the text that is a 3D alphabet, and then finally, in the third, we will create the reflections and shadows and the text. So let's begin with our tutorial. We'll start with the text and type our letter A. Now scale it up and we'll choose the appropriate font. So I think this is good. We'll use the regular. We'll using normal UI and the font is regular. Now we'll scale this up a little bit more, change its color to white so that it is more visible. Now after we got that, we'll do one thing here. We'll just scale it up a little bit more, and now convert this into object form. To convert that, we'll go to object and expand it, and in this way we got it into object form. Now we'll do some modification here. Now we'll select the pen tool and we'll delete our few points. There's subtract it out from the object. We don't need this. I think we will not be needing this. And this, I'll just do some adjustment with the anchor point selection. Just click and drag this one. Just click and drag. Fine. Now select the inner portion and just check out. Okay, we need some adjustment here. We need to delete few points more here. We'll use this. We'll delete this portion. We'll delete this point and this point. So, and this also. So, now with the convert anchor point to selected, we'll just make this little bit inner. This one, like this, and we'll break these points like this. And now we'll select this point and just drag it in the same way. This one same way, and this one also. Now the next thing we need to do is little bit adjustment. Here it's good, it's good. Okay, now with the direct selection tool, we can select each points individually. Now let's do the adjustment. We'll select this down a little bit, downward, dragging it down. We'll just move a little bit this one. Okay, we'll just move this little bit this side, and we'll just make sure it's not that much extended. We'll need to follow the curve, so we'll do that like this. This one's nice. This one a little bit cooler. This one we can move it a little bit up, and this one a little bit sideways like this. So we got that. Now once you have done that, we'll do the first step which we have told. We'll create the sphere. Now with the ellipse tool selected, draw the circle, and with the eye picker and shift alt pressed, click this color. We have already prepared the color palette for our colors pro object, so we will be using that. And now with the gradient option, just adjust it nicely. Okay, now we'll duplicate one more time this sphere. Control C, Control F, and scale it down and little bit twist it to an angle and place it there. Now this time we'll use this color. So eye picker, shift alt press, select it, and you can see in the gradient, you can see this color is both angle side it's white, but in the one side it's opacity is 0 and the other side is 100. So we're using that. We'll do something like that. You can see it's totally blended here, and here we got the highlight. Now we'll bring this object on the top, arrange to front, and scale it up. So we'll bring this object on the top. Now place it here properly and scale it up. You can scale it up a little more. You have to make sure that this object, the sphere is under it, and the curve should follow it. The curve should be followed. So like that. So now the next thing is to select this, go to Effect, 3D, Extrude and Bevel. And in the with this option, we'll do some interesting stuff. You can preview it here. We can increase the perspective to firstly around 100, maybe 110, around that. Now we'll reduce the extrude depth to around 20 maybe, or maybe 28 and 27. Now we'll play with the angles. So we'll just move and check it out which angle suits. And I'm doing it with the help of my scroll in the mouse. So I'm just scrolling it, and you can see the movement in the text. So I'm just doing that. So I'm just selecting the angles, and with the scroll in the mouse, just rotating it, you can see the movement on the text. So we can do that. This one we need. Yeah, this is good. Okay, fine. We'll do some little angle like this. Okay. And bit like that, this one little bit, this one like that, fine. And after when you get the proper angle, just click the OK button. Now with the selection tool, just select the object and go to object and expand appearance, and again expand it. So you got the object. Now ungroup it maybe twice or thrice, and so that all the pieces are separate. I think all the pieces are now separate. Now you can easily fill the respective colors, but before that we got to do one step here. So select this and give it some stroke color. So we'll select that and fill it with some white stroke color. Okay, now we'll give some thickness, and it has got 1 point, so I think this is nice. We'll give, or maybe 1 point. You can give the points around 2, and we have increased the thickness of the stroke. Now we'll do select the object and go to object and expand it. The reason why we are doing is we need this stroke to be in the object form. I'm going to fill it some different color to this. So we have got separate object of the stroke, and this is separate. So now it is time for filling the gradient color, so we'll do that. So I'll just select all of this and bring it beside the colors, and now we'll select this object with the eye picker and shift alt pressed. You can select the color, and with the gradient tool you can adjust it. So we'll do that. Before that, we'll just select the fill color and now do the adjustment here. So with the gradient color, just move it here wherever you want, and scale. You can even scale the highlight portions like that, and here we go. So we'll select this object, and in the pathfinder we'll just combine it to form it into one object. So select this portions, combine it, this one and this one, combine. Now fill it with separate colors. So with all selected at once, with the shift and alt, with first the eye picker and with the shift and alt pressed, just select these colors. Now with the gradient color, you can independently select each pieces and edit. So we'll zoom in and just work on that. So with the gradient, just play with it. So here we need dark and light over there. In the same way, we'll select this with the gradient, dark to light, like that, light to dark. Like that. We'll select this, and with the gradient selection we'll just move this that side and scale it up a little bit, and like that. So we need here some darkness and here also some darkness. That's why we're doing that. with the side a little bit, and you can scale it a little bit more. In the same way, we'll select this piece, and with the gradient selected, we'll do that stuff. So we'll scale this up and just scale it down if it's huge, on like that. So we got a nice glow here. We need to keep that the same way. Now the important step. One important step here. We select this piece and duplicate it twice. Control C, Control F, and F twice. I have done that. Now we'll select the upper and just move it a little bit. And I can scale it up a little bit so that there's some okay. After that, we'll select these two pieces. I'm selecting the upper and this one because I have duplicated twice. So the original one is behind that, so will not affect that. Go to the Pathfinder and just intersect. And in the gradient color, push this color a little bit outside. So we got a little darker effect here. You can see we got a darker effect. In the same way, we'll just move this little bit sideways and we'll select that earlier one, intersect it, and with the gradient color selected, just move it a little bit outside. And you get the darker portion here, and that has got a nice reflection. You can see it has got nice shadow effect. Now we'll do this. We'll select this outer stroke which we have formed, and that's the object now, and we'll fill it with the eye picker. Just Alt and press and select this color. Now with the gradient selected, just move like this. We need lighter portion here and darker on the background, so we're doing that. And now we'll see that. Now you can see it has got a nice effect here. We'll reduce the opacity to around 60 and it will give more effect. Now we have got that effect. Now we are left with one more last step here. We select everything and deselect this sphere and just duplicate it with the Alt press drag, and you duplicate it. So we'll select all these pieces and combine it and fill it with some plain color or maybe gray color with the eye picker. Just select it dark and bring it in the front. Bring it here. With the help of Control and the square bracket key on your keyboard, you can move the dark object below the 3D text. The reason why we made this dark text is because we need some shadow effect here. So we have created that and we have put it below the alphabet. And now we'll reduce its opacity to around 60 and we will give some effect here. We'll go to gradient and maybe this. And we'll do some adjustment. So we'll fill it with black color. So we'll fill it with black and this side also black, and in one side we'll reduce the opacity to 0. Now we'll select this and make this 0. So now we'll keep this linear, make sure it's linear, and now we'll just adjust the gradient color. So from here we need the darker on the below and lighter on the top. Fine, like that, and you can see it. So we can even reduce it a little bit more if it's highly visible to you, like 50, and place it there below. Now we can see that we have created that text effect, we have created the reflection, we have created the shadow, and we can even move it a little bit. Fine, that's like that. Now last thing we are left with is to create the text. So we'll use the text and type out our stuff. Aragon Aragon. Just do some stuff here. We'll give it some font. So we are using text Gary Adventure text. So we'll select that with the R picker. Just select that color eye and just scale it up. So this is the text we are using. We'll just place it below there and you can see it. Keep it there, this one properly. So we have completed our logo, in which we have first prepared the sphere, then the text and the alphabet. So this is how we can create these kinds of logo. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, You can press the subscribe button. Thank you.